Hey, I'd like to welcome you to another episode of the Mission Matters Money Podcast, your source for all things money. My name is Adam Torres. You can follow me on Instagram at AskAdamTorres. Keep up with my book releases, book tour schedule, signings, all that other good stuff. Always love to connect with you there. And as always, if you'd like to apply to become a co-author of one of my upcoming books, just head on over to the website, missionmatters.com, and click on Become an Author to apply. All right, so today I have Elizabeth Karwowski on the line, and she's CEO over at Get Credit Healthy. Elizabeth, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Adam. I'm excited to be on the show.
So I say we just jump right in. I mean, you've been in the business for a long time. Tell us more about Get Credit Healthy.
I'd love to. Yeah, when people say you've been in the business a long period of time, I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm still super young. What are you talking about? I'm just.
I need more than a year or two. Come on.
Oh, it's been over 20 plus years, right? And you know, here at Get Credit Healthy, what we do is we've created a technology platform that allows us to connect lenders with consumers with our network of credit HUD nonprofit counselors. And really have this circle of individuals that are finding true success in how to become financially and credit wealthy.
So what I like about your model is that you're really covering three, let's just say, main bases: the lenders, the consumers, and the obviously the counselors. So I think it's a unique model. I don't think that everybody addresses all the different angles. What do you find interesting or different about your culture and approach?
You know, we believe in customers for life. From our lend partners, they really value their customers. The problem. And taking it and making, you know, some of the terminology I might use, let's take a step down and say, what is the real problem? The problem right now is if you go to a lending institution, a bank, you don't qualify, they might tell you to go down the street. And as they tell you to go down the street to one of these nonprofits or one of these entities, you really don't have that connectivity. There's no way of knowing, are you getting the right support? And then they're not upheld to a standard. So what we've created is a new standard in the industry of saying, hey, our nonprofits have to uphold to key performance metrics, have to uphold to a specific way of doing business so that they could see that you as a consumer find success in whatever that might be, whether it's increasing your credit score to a 680 from a 600, whether it's having the capacity of purchasing a home. They have that standard, and the true value is that everyone is working on the same platform to make sure we're upholding to that success.
No, that's awesome. I love it. And the whole ethos of having a client and having them for life, I mean, that's different because credit isn't something that goes away and it evolves and it changes and people have different, you know, or people and businesses, I should say, have different cycles that they go in their life, and some are better than others. And getting back in the game if they're not doing well or even increasing their position if they are doing well, I mean, those things are all relevant. So that being said.
No, Adam. Yeah, you brought up a good thing is that credit affects all of us, right? And there's so many different models out there and platforms, and it becomes so ultra confusing to the regular consumer. I mean, it becomes ultra confusing to lenders, right? Because if you go to a lender right now and you pulled your score online, next thing you know, you're like, oh, I have a 700. And then you go and apply and you're like, I have a 6 what? Why is that happening when I pulled my credit and people just don't understand the detail of, you know, who is FICO and who's Vantage Score and how many different models are out there and all this fun, interesting stuff that I live in, right? But the most important part is how do you get that information out to consumers, make it in a way that it's interesting at the same time as it's interesting that they understand it, because it's scary. This is the information that impacts you from getting a 3% for a car or a 4% for a home loan versus a 7 or 8 or a 20%, right? That's a huge financial burden when you really can't have a good credit profile, which leads to great financial success.
No, that's awesome. So what should consumers and businesses be thinking about in credit going into 2020? So new year, new decade, all that good stuff that we like to say. What are some things they should be thinking about?
From a business perspective, you know, we do assessment reports for our partners to really point out how many people they have turned down and what is that opportunity. As I said, our partners are looking for customers for life. They, as anyone in business, you spend money to market to these customers. And mm-hmm. by making sure you care for them the right way, all of a sudden they remember your name. So for businesses, I'd like to say, look at if you pull credit as one of your key components or factors in determining whether or not a consumer qualifies, and you're not focusing on that, you're missing out on a huge opportunity. For consumers, you know, it's the basic steps that I always like to tell even my friends. Have you pulled your report lately? If you haven't, go to annualcreditreport.com. There's a lot of free services that keep you at least up to date. They might not provide the score that that lenders use, but at least it's keeping you up to date as far as what's going on. You know, the first step is just understanding where you stand with your credit report. So if you do need assistance, you can at least take those necessary steps.
That's awesome. So, Elizabeth, if somebody is listening to this and they want more information on Get Credit Healthy, I mean, what's the best way for them to reach out?
The best way to reach one of our nonprofit affiliate groups that really focus on our consumers is through our website, getcredithealthy.com. Or they could, you know, we have many different social media posts. It's all with Get Credit Healthy or Get Credit Health. Or just calling us at 305-676-2221. And we do have our nonprofits waiting to speak to someone and give them the needed guidance.
That's awesome. Well, hey, Elizabeth, it's been awesome having you on the show today. I love the work you're doing, love how you're helping people both on the business side and the consumer side with their credit and keeping clients for life. I mean, it's a big deal. I love the point you bring up that, you know, you spend money marketing to get these clients in the door, to send them just down the street. I mean, if you can retain, if you can do other things, it's just a great business model you've created and just a really holistic way to help people on both sides of the spectrum. So awesome stuff there. And to the audience, as always, thank you for tuning in. Hope you got a lot of value out of this. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to the podcast, leave me a review on the iTunes store, and if you're watching this on our YouTube channel, Mission Matters Money, definitely give us a subscribe there, but also let's keep the conversation going there. I'd love to hear what you thought over in the YouTube community. And Elizabeth, thanks again for coming on the show.